I was intrigued by the discussion of FinOps as a financial operations as a specialty. This is something we started seeing a few years back, particularly focused on Amazon Web Services, because AWS has developed so many services and so many different ways to use it, and it's all very complicated. And everybody's heard the horror stories of somebody who didn't realize they were misconfiguring something or left something running when they thought they had turned it off, and suddenly a huge bill shows up in their invoice. So that was sort of the first place that we saw it, because in a way it's kind of low hanging fruit, because there's savings that can generate, that can cost justify the effort that you put into it. It's pretty clear that investing in that kind of expertise is valuable. And this gets to one of my one of the things I have a difficult time getting my head around with repatriation, is that I don't know how many people there are that have that expertise. And I think it's certainly less than the number required to meet the kind of savings that people might envision out of this. It's kind of a new specialty, but it's not a simple one either. What are you seeing, hearing about how this specialization develops, and how companies are going to use it?
There's no doubt that there is tremendous savings seen from the switch to upfront CapEx investments in information technology to subscription, right? There is, right? And it's really, you can't argue that, especially when the use case is right. But unfortunately, that feeling gets soured as the rising monthly bills come in for services that sometimes, like you mentioned, nobody knows that are even turned on. I'm going to quote J.R. Stormont, who is the executive director at the FinOps Foundation, quote, "The dirty little secret of cloud spend is that the bill never really goes down." That's a heck of a statement, right? Because realistically speaking, right, a lot of folks that are using cloud are only going to see that cost continue to go up. Let's talk about expertise for a second. FinOps is the process of actively and continuously measuring, monitoring, and mitigating the cost and understanding the value of what lives in the cloud versus what that value persistently could be if it was managed in an on-prem environment. Now, there's different use cases. If you are an organization that's just only persistently developing applications and services, CDN functions that are leveraging a NoSQL database that's distributed throughout multiple carriers throughout the United States, cool. You probably don't want to have that stuff on-premise. Use that cloud, use the low latency models, and that's a perfect model for you. Let's say you are a storage or some kind of a caching mechanism, or maybe something else where you require more of that physical architecture, right? Suddenly dedicated physical gear in the cloud. Oh my God, Rich, I don't want to even look at that bill. I don't want to see it. I don't care which cloud provider you're working with. That stuff goes up really, really quick. That's where you have to start making some of those introspective, you know, conversations or decisions, right? Does this make sense for me to keep it in the cloud versus what do I need to keep on-prem? The first step is just asking the questions. Oftentimes, we've always felt that cloud computing is set it and forget it, let it keep running. It's working for me. It's in the cloud. It sounds really cool, and I can say that to my customers, but really, it's not bringing much value to the business. As an architect, as somebody who's worked as a cloud architect, and someone comes to me and says, Bill, I've got workloads in Azure, GCP, AWS. I don't know if they should be there. You do cost comparisons. You do architectural development and deployment comparisons. You see what's required on-premise, what you can build out, what you can lease out versus what you have out there. And you can understand the balance between what needs to be in the cloud and what needs to be on-prem. That's the change that's been happening in our industry, is that simply more people are doing that exercise.